pipes, but what's the process you're going to use to improve their technique? Give us some tactics that you could use to get to improve their technique.
And the basic one that you're doing is a bit chunky. At the person of rowing, they step forward, they need to play a step. So they can't be premeditated, they always play the net shot. So you're getting it to look like this, but they're actually the same. And the minute that something changes, they need to be able to adjust their shot straight away. So they can't be...
So what are you doing there?
So you're taking the decision making away from them from the start.
Yeah.
So they are not focused on just doing this one shot, because then they open up to a cross court or a straight position too early. So you make it that they're not in control of what they're about to do. And then once you move or make some sort of prop towards what they have to do, they have to use the same setup but produce a different shot.
Okay. Let's try that. Let's work with that. Let's start with that as our basic exercise. All right? Come down now. Coming in and playing at the block, because he knows he's going to play a block. Here, because he knows he's got different options, what he's doing is, actually he's preparing early. He's getting into position earlier, because he's thinking, I've got to flick, I've got to play net, I've got to play cross. So already his position is actually better.
So basically what we're going to do is ask the players, so to give the players two choices at the midcourt, forehand midcourt, either to hit straight or cross. And pretty much, you know,
yeah, layer free for them to do whatever they want.
So, you know, the voice that you want. Three, drop,
smash.
Yep. But he must pick one, right?
So we're going to give them like a free choice to do it, like say like a clear, even if I don't say clear, or cross drop. And he does it free at his own field first.
Yeah.
So we just go with that.
Yep.
Take away a bit of that predictability that, yep, he knows he's getting clear, he's made up his mind. We're not going to shuttle rather than making up late. But then we're going to add a bit more restriction and then just see. So Brian will tell him if he wants a clear or a cross drop, and we'll work on doing that as late as possible to see how his technique holds up to that. Good. We say you look at his movement, he's not really doing any. So we want to add that in as well, a little bit more movement. And keep it taking up that energy up. So from there, the next step that I close. Throw the line in.
So keep up your normal movement?
Yeah, with movement.
So shift just to the front, snap, come back to the back, and then I'll tell you.
Okay.
Coaches, thank you. Thank you. What did you see? Was that good coaching process? Good coaching process. I've got a problem with the second one. Because you have to be really careful on this one. Because what happened on the second one was, where the call was coming clear or drop, when it was a drop, the call was coming later, so the shuttle was being taken later. I wanted to take it. Was it okay in terms of progression, but you've got to be very careful with how you set it up. Because the player's here waiting, there's no movement, he's waiting, and it's dropped. There's no challenge to him to take it early. Actually, he did it a lot better when he put the movement in, actually the technique improved. So again, just as coaches, you have to be aware of what you're actually setting up. It was logical steps, but with that particular player, technically it didn't work. It worked when you put him under pressure, when he started to have to move, when he was coming out, then he was looking to get up. In the first instance, he wasn't, so he was just taking it round by round. So you need to keep your eye on what's happening technically. Okay, we're going to do two or three examples. Which group's this? One person, then two, so one girl and then the second girl joining. Yep. Four steps, just a quick demonstration of each step.
Okay, two. All right, so we started off our progression with the stand feeding, stationary.
We've seen that, yeah, okay. First step is stand feed, yeah.
And then after that, we add the movement and then make it into a pattern, so like
left, right, left, right. Okay, yeah, let's start there. And stop. Thank you. That's good. Thank you, players. Progressive coaching. What was the technique? What was the objective? What was the outcome? What was the outcome you were looking for at the end of the process? Okay. So, but how did you challenge predictability in that sequence? In the last one, so she could go straight or cross there. So you introduced straight or cross on the single shuttle rallying situation. Okay. Any comments, coaches? Okay. I would go back to technique and have a very clear impression, a very clear picture of what you're trying to achieve. Because on the hand feed, I can see it's okay feed. Player, nice movements, good legs, but I didn't see the quality of the technique. And I didn't see a fixation that would have allowed her to play straight or cross on that original feed. So the original feed wasn't allowing for the eventual outcome. And you've got to keep the outcome very firmly in the front of your mind. Eventually you want it to be able to come in here and play straight or cross. Is it straight or is it cross? Is it straight or is it flip? That's the situation you want to get to. And the first feed actually probably didn't allow for her to get into that position, because she was going left, right. It was quite sort of, it was quite quick. As I say, nothing wrong with it, but was she able to get into that position every time? I'm not sure. Yes. I mean, there's no definite rights and wrongs here. What I'm saying is, be very, very clear in your mind when you start out with step one, what step four or step five is and what you actually want it to look like. And there's a step 10, because it's got to go into a match and look like that in a match as well. So what you're trying to do is build that skill and build the resistance of that skill and the gradually increased difficulty and increased decision-making situations. Yeah? If you start it off and you don't get the picture that you're looking for, then it's very difficult at the end to...